call to order the select board meeting of August 14th. Jody Lavoy-Carnes is not present with us tonight, and Salma is not present, but Corey is here taking the minutes for the board. Thank you, Corey, for bringing this step in to do this. Appreciate it. Normally, we start with approval of minutes, but this set of minutes, we just had a meeting with just Jody and me, and so we will postpone that. So we'll go right to community input. Sir, would you like to address the board? And you need to start by giving us your name and road address.
Start with me?
Mr. Chase, you're up.
Yes.
Yeah, I just explained to him that I left my hearing in the Army with...
I'm sorry. We need your name and your address.
Can I come up there?
You certainly can. Can we bring it?
Do you want a chair? Do you want us to carry and put the table up?
Or just bring a chair?
Yeah, this is fine.
Sorry. I won't tell a soul.
That's a big secret.
I won't tell a soul. So your name is Mr. Chase. What's your first name, please?
Yeah, Bob Chase.
Bob Chase, and your road?
I live on 12 Short Street.
Short Street, okay.
Right on the corner of Short and Silver.
Okay. I know the area. I don't know the individual houses, but I know the area.
So what happened was I missed the last day of calling Avatar. And the reason I missed them was there were 3 days I couldn't get in here. And then I was in the hospital, had pneumonia. I was in the hospital for 4 days. Then after that, they took me by ambulance to a rehab facility. Mm-hmm. And that was basically a waste of time there. I finally told them either get a doctor to get me out of here or I'm gonna walk out. But then they had visiting nurses come into the house not every day, they just started every day. And so they kept me pretty much tied down. And I didn't do anything. And normally I pay every single bill the first day of the month. The second day of the month, I don't know anybody had died. Except for my mortgage on the house. Where am I when I said that?
You're probably...
But anyway, they kept coming until my lungs were thoroughly dried, free, and they were loaded with water. And the doctor told me when I left the hospital that I was a lucky guy to be walking up at my age of 91 years old. So I was very lucky to be walking out of there and having a
phone. Congratulations. Congratulations.
Yeah,
it's an achievement, isn't it?
Yeah. Well, I was pleased with it, I'll tell you that. You know, really. I've been lucky. I've had a good life. And I had a military career and have all my own businesses. And in any company I worked with, I got to the top in no time at all. And I retired about 70, I was 75 when I retired. And so I've been hanging around up here for a long time. You know.
Well, what can we help you with? What did you?
What happened? I missed the Avatar agent when he was to come to my house. I was up here 3 days before, and I didn't know they had a summer hours. So I missed getting this information. Then the other problem is I have macular degeneration in my right eye, my left eye, and my right eye, and I've had surgically implanted lenses into my eyes behind the pupil, and I can't read small print. As far as the distance is concerned, I'm fine.
So Andrea, this is someone else that I think we got an email about, and there's a letter in the folder here discussing it. Set up an appointment because there was a miscommunication in the mail.
Oh, is
so? I think Andrea could just reach out to Avatar and help Mr. Chase get an appointment.
Yes, Andrea. The email we got from Andrea was somebody else. Though.
Separate. Yes.
Okay. Yes. So we will arrange to have you meet with Avatar this week. That's what we're going to try to do, because they're around Wednesday and Thursday. They're around 3 days this week. I think Wednesday, Thursday, Friday. Talking to people about their...
This is too late, is that what you're telling me?
It is not too late to talk to Avatar.
Okay.
They, whether they feel the need to go back to your house, I don't know, but they'll talk to you about the value that they gave to your land.
Let me tell you what this, about a year ago, I was gonna refinance the house through Bank of America, and I called a real estate agent who did appraisals. He come up and appraised the house and the land at $365,000. And with Avatar, I didn't bring the paper with me, you know, age.
It's okay, it's all right.
And that's what I use for this year.
It works.
As long as it got your attention.
That's right.
And I have no trouble going back to where I was.
You forgot to bring, so you've got your assessed, your new assessed value.
Yeah.
You had an appraiser.
Yeah, they appraised it at $365,000. Now, Avatar, the land is 0.865 acres. It's not a full acre. And if you know it, you know where the house is?
No, I just know that general area.
This is on the corner of Short and Portland Ave. So there's a big white Victorian.
Okay. Yeah.
Where there's some granite blocks had to be put on his lawn,
okay.
The trucks used to go up and over.
You
he owns the lot in front, though, too, on the side. So
you know where the house is. If you notice the driveway, the one that's in front of the barn.
I don't know anything about your side lot, but I know where your house is.
There's a big mountain there. And the reason for that, that's the leach field. Because when I bought the house, there was a hole in the ground with a bunch of rocks in it. And it's a four-family apartment house, a small apartment house. And it was all the refuge from the four families went into this hole in the back. When I had the DMA stepped in it, you know, really, the background. So I said, that's it. So I called a fellow from Southburg to come over and put up a leach field. And as they tested the land, and now this all goes to them charging me between $90,000 and $99,000 for that land, Avatar. And the guy who put in the leach field could not find a piece of land that would leach. It was all full of water. Couldn't build on it, couldn't do anything with it. So we had to come over right beside the driveway and build this big high hill, which is about 6 foot high, at least six or 7 feet high. Fill it with gravel and sand, and that's the leach field. But all the rest of the land is useless. Now there's also a big piece of land that runs across Route 4. And that was all just full of woods and old dead trees. And I had Urban Tree Service come in and trim all the trees and everything out of it. And that's nothing but mud.
Well, so I think what you're saying is that you feel that the value that they've placed, particularly on the land piece of your property, is okay. So we're going to try to, because we can't address that directly, because we're working through Avatar. So we're going to try to get an appointment for you this week.
God bless you.
So I'm going to borrow Michael's pen, or I'll write it down. My thing is here. How do we contact you? Your phone number?
Well, 603-749-4687.
603-749-4687.
Correct.
Are you going to be generally available Wednesday, Thursday, or Friday of this week?
Thursday and Friday of this week, I will be here.
Wednesday?
Nope. Thursday, I have a doctor's appointment.
Well, we'll try to figure something out.
Yeah, but the appointment is at, they thought I had bladder cancer. They took out two tumors, but the last time it was clear. So hopefully, we're going to this trip here with Thursday. We'll all be clear,
okay.
You know, really. And but then I'll be home Thursday afternoon, and I'll be here all day Friday.
So you can come in. You'd be able to come in. I think they're going to meet people here.
Oh, okay.
For like 50, to talk things over. Now, maybe after talking to you, they might want to go back out.
Okay.
I don't know.
Okay.
But this is for like a meeting with them here in Town Hall to review, you know, what they gave you. So please bring, if you can, well, they would have it anyway. But
if you have that other assessment that you had done, you want to bring stuff like that with you.
Well, I have my sister. You know Glenn Chase?
I know who's on.
Yeah, well, Glenn's my son. So I have Glenn.
Maybe Glenn come with you, maybe not.
I have
Glenn.
Oh,
Glenn is your son.
I didn't know you.
Yeah, they're in Colorado right now, he and his wife Wendy. And have you been in point?
No, I only have met Glenn because he's an alternate.
She's my mother, she's my daughter, she's my daughter-in-law.
Then you're a lucky man.
She's my mistress. That's what I tell her all the time. I really, I was bringing something over to eat, I would bring me flowers, and she's a good person, she really is. But I'll bring Glenn with me on Friday, whatever it is.
That would be good, I think.
That would be wonderful, I'd really appreciate it.
Sure, all right. Thank you so much, nice to meet you, Mr. Chase.
Nice to meet you, thank you very much.
Be on the lookout for the phone call, okay, from Avatar, they're gonna call you to make an appointment.
Okay, now, what I was doing, I'll look for it on my answering machine, if I'm not back from the doctor.
Okay.
It may take a day or two, because we, you know, we won't be able to touch base with them until sometime tomorrow. But you'll hear something from either us or Avatar this week.
I gotta tell you something, I won't be there on Wednesday.
It's okay, we'll keep trying.
I spend all my time on Wednesday and Tuesday buying toys, and I give them away at Christmas time.
It's very nice.
And right now, this Wednesday, I have a whole mess of stuff in, I have to bring up a daycare center.
That's a very nice thing to do.
Well, there are many people that do it.
Good for you. All right, take care.
Hey, thanks, Shannon.
Any other community input? Okay, department head, you seem to be the only one here. I'd say come right up, there's no sense.
Okay.
That's too far away, I don't know what happened.
Well, I have some good news.
All right, I can use some good news.
As you know, I don't mind growling on behalf of the town of Rollinsville.
And we appreciate that.
Much appreciated.
And last week we spoke about the grant for the computer system, the Homeland Security Computer Hat. They're gonna take it over. Every year was our $50,000 upgrade for the radio system as the matching grant. So, I have the paperwork right here, and just like the last one we did, we actually have a copy of the sample minutes of the meeting that they would like you have to put in for the specific verbiage into the official record.
Yeah, we'll pass this, can we keep this and pass it on to Tori?
Yes, that's your copy, yes, yeah.
Okay. So, just remind me, the grant was for all the radio stuff, pardon my lack of precision.
No, the grant was for just the repair on top of the water tower. The warrant article was for the radio upgrade for the police vehicles and the portables. That was $50,000. The repeater is going to be about $25,000. It's 23 some change, but then by the time you get Mr. Electric up there, it's probably going to be a few hundred dollars to bring the electrical from their in-ground unit they have now over to the base part of the antenna system.
Were they anticipating a grant though, and then they said that we didn't qualify?
Well, right. Originally, discussing it with the folks on screen, they would say, yeah, we'll take your $50,000 is matching towards this. So you get the town one.
I'm confused, so I need to get myself.
I know, I think you're there. We had to change it at the last minute because.
And then, yeah, when I spoke with our rep, he said, well, they'll pay for a half repeater because they won't use your $50,000 radio upgrade as your half match. When I spoke with his supervisor, Liz, she said, yep, no problem, we'll pay for the entire thing. We'll use the $50,000. Some change.
All right, so the public safety, it was Article 12. So to see, if this is this where it all comes from, to see if the town will vote to raise an appropriate $75,000 to replace, okay, with $50,000 coming from us,
correct,
of the CIP, and $25,000 hopefully from the grant. And so, and then, so the next step was you came to us and.
And we at first they said, no, we're not going to give you $25,000,
right.
Give you $12,000 some
yes,
change
okay.
out of it.
Yep.
But now they're saying they're going to pay for the whole thing.
Okay, so we are going to get.
So you are going to get $23,545.
All right, so then all we have to do, we'll draw the $50,000 from the CIP. We have the.
We've already done that.
We've already done that
for the radio portion,
okay.
Yes.
All right. So we're going to take the 25, yes and no. We have to take the 25 though from the Homeland Security line, the reimbursable, reimbursable line.
Yes.
Okay, all right, well, that's good news, I think I'm now with the program.
Okay, so I have the grant agreement here.
Okay, should we do this before we sign, probably?
Probably should, yes.
Yes. All right, so, so I'll need you, Mike, to formulate a motion first, because then that goes in, that's not, it's not a resolution, really, it just says what we did.
I move that the board accept the terms of the Emergency Management Performance Grant as presented for the State Department of Homeland Security, in the amount of $23,545.
I second that. Any discussion? All those in favor say aye.
Aye.
Aye. So Corey, what you will be putting in the minutes is this, the town of Rollinsford Board of Selectmen, in a majority vote, which we just did, accepted the terms of the blah, blah, blah.
As people verbatim to that.
Yeah, so you can just.
Just copy this?
Just copy that, yep.
So we have the grant agreement here, and Mike in the pad, one of the previous ones. Signature, name and title, all pages.
And initials.
Initial, and if you would, and if you don't mind, since Jody's not here tonight, I will sign these subrecipient number three, or part of the grant as well.
Yep.
So I'll sign this tomorrow in front of the JP or notary, and date it at the exact same time. So you just need to sign your title, an initial, one, and then two from all.
And you'll get a JP.
I'll get a JP. I'll let you know.
Thank you. Thank you very much. So we're now signing the grant. Acceptance of the grant provisions. Name and title. So initials on every page. I didn't date it. Is that 14? One of those, or at least one of those needs to date maybe too.
Don't date it. I'll date it tomorrow with the
okay, all right, all right, all right. We'll just, yeah, okay. Never mind.
Okay. This way, that matched the date that she sent it. So. Joy, our bulletproof vests are in lifespan of 5 years when they're worn every day, and this December we'll make the 5 year mark, so it takes a couple of months to be outfitted and arrived, so and we'll have for January to order it now, so I'm proposing a purchase order of $800 made up to Neptune's. Come out of the equipment line item, excuse me, uniform line item for our vest for Officer and Joy.
I move purchase order number 1259 to Neptune Uniforms for one bulletproof vest for $800.
Second.
Is this the whole vest or just the
plates that go on the whole vest?
And are they roughly, I guess, are they made for each person? Or are they?
Yeah, they're fitted for each,
person.
Okay. All set? I'll call the question. All those in favor say aye.
Aye.
Do you want to see this purchase order, Corey?
Sure. Yeah. More data, the better.
Yeah.
I will let you take a look at this real quick. We're looking to purchase the flammable storage unit for our garage downstairs. That's something that our insurance carrier has zinged us on in the past, and the drug loss committee also recommends that we take care of that issue right away.
Okay.
So air purchase number 1258, we'll order from Amazon.com, the cheapest I could find, so I reimburse myself.
How much is it?
It's $614.59. And that'll come out of our equipment line item.
All the cards have a grant, so we don't have one left.
No, we should consider it. But Caroline's not here, but look, we should consider that.
Yeah, I think that doesn't
work. You know, administratively,
yeah.
I think it's a good idea. I think we can talk about how we might do that.
Purchase order number 1258 to Amazon.
Well, that should be to me.
Okay.
To purchase my card.
For one Just Right flammable safety cabinet for $614.39, and includes shipping.
A second. Any discussion or questions?
We didn't move anything out of the equipment line when we were. Okay.
All those in favor say aye.
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 Make sure you weren't counting on something. We weren't all thinking about it.
No, I got it out. I did rob him, but he would willingly. He
offered
it up.
Good.
Just did not come out of this line. Oops. Is there just one here?
It's the
I've, as a result of our last joint loss committee meeting, I've arranged for CPR and AED training for town employees, as well as two police officers that weren't able to make our prior training. That's now scheduled for October 11th, 5 p.m. here at the Town Hall, and it's a cost of $3 per participant. So we're asking the board to send out a notice to town employees that this is your chance to get certified with the use of the AED and the CPR.
Okay, so the date again?
October 11th.
10, 11, 17.
5 p.m. Town Hall.
Approximately how long session is it?
2.5 to 3 hours.
If we wanted to participate in that, could we pay the $3 in training costs?
I think the township paid you $3. It's $3 for the card itself. The instructor is going to donate his services.
Oh, that's great.
$3 is to get the card from
Red Cross
Heart Sale.
So it's AED and CPR certification?
Correct.
Do they need to register ahead of time? Should they let us know? Is that
preferable? We should have a number ahead of time, yes.
Probably won't, may not go up until Caroline gets back.
That's fine.
We still have time. So. Great, thank you for that.
Okay, there's been some concern with the Ford Explorers and possible emission problems.
Yes.
I've actually ordered, and received them today and installed them, two carbon detectors. A lot of the problems went on, bought the ones that just get to your house and stick them in there. But they don't realize when it's to your house, they don't operate 24/7. They cycle on and off every now and then. So I would get the kind that you plug in the servo and it's on all the time.
Mm-hmm.
And these actually trigger at 3 parts per million, and which is well below the accepted amount of CO.
Mm-hmm.
So we now have one, and hopefully the two newest Ford Explorers.
Mm-hmm.
I don't anticipate a problem with those vehicles. We haven't any problems as of yet. So, but
better be safe.
Better be safe when they recognize that there was a problem.
Yeah.
So,
well,
the vehicle's cracking or something like that.
Is that what's happening? What's causing it?
Yeah. And then when the folks, you know, drill into the floors and put their cages and reading and stuff like that, is, you know, some of the. The fumes are coming in from those holes and whatnot. So.
Okay.
Some more good news. Our officer successfully passed the physical agility test at the police academy today.
Yay.
So in 2 weeks, he's out of here for 16 weeks. So Newcastle with flying colors, he's very happy, he's very excited to get started.
And has he been doing field work?
No.
No, he's, okay.
He's done two ride-alongs so far, he's going to do one more, I think this weekend, with Officer Hancock.
Okay, so when he comes back?
When he comes back, that's when he'll start working and doing field work.
There was someone, or wasn't there someone?
Well, the last one.
Yeah, tried to.
We tried to do the FTO part first.
Yeah.
Then it's done with the academy. Whatever it is, didn't work, so.
Well, good, it is good news, so we'll hopefully continue good news, and he has a good 4 weeks, 16 weeks?
16 weeks. That's all that I have for you, but I do see on the agenda you have something for me, the old highway department.
Well, Jody is trying to get someone to come get it, you know, we've been on, so that's just there to, for her to talk to it. She's not here tonight, so I don't know if she's heard anything, she didn't send any emails.
I know, I think it was last week, that Burke sent someone down to look at the building. And according to the lieutenant, he wants it, so.
He just needs to connect with us somehow and some more, and we need to write a contract, which is what the municipal associate, even if it's just a buck, we need to have an official document that he's, this is what he's doing there and all that, so.
Well, we'll check for Jody when she gets back.
Okay, yeah, all right.
Anything else? All right, perfect, well, thank you.
Thank you.
Enjoy.
Hey, Jeff. Hey, how you doing?
Hi, Jeff, come on up.
Sit here for a minute.
All right.
Didn't know if the board had anything for me tonight, just wanted to stop by, see if you guys have any questions.
Well, we got the email from Aaron, did you see that?
Yeah, no, I saw it all right.
Did you call him?
I did, actually.
Thank you.
Yeah, so, that's what I was actually going to talk to you guys about tonight.
What time did that happen, Jeff?
What's that?
The water main break?
I was at 11:00 this morning, 10:00 this morning.
Did they work last Friday?
Nope.
How come?
They had a funeral to it. Somebody in the company.
Because, you know, it's just odd, I mean, I was there, I was at the school Thursday, grade school, so I went to see Culver, of course. And then at the end of the day on Friday, I was, for whatever reason, I think it was out and about, I went to Brandmore. I went to see it again, I said, huh, I don't think anything's happened, so they didn't work Friday.
They did not, no, they had something going on within, somebody passed, so.
Yeah.
The whole company.
Well, Aaron gave us a very detailed email.
Oh, yeah.
So, things are not quite up to snuff, and so, will you be there tomorrow at 6:30?
I will be there.
Is there any reason that a board member should be there? I mean, Aaron will be there and you will be there.
I think Aaron's got it taken care of.
Yeah, he's good.
Yeah, we had a great conversation this afternoon, probably an hour's worth of talking.
Yeah.
And I listed everything that they're not doing, what do you think?
Well, he's very thorough, so he did a good job explaining it. I mean, it's not encouraging, but you know, as long as you get on top of it at some point, then.
I wasn't here last week, so I apologize. Maybe I missed an email somewhere, but so are we not pleased with the level of work? I mean, obviously we're not pleased that they have this issue today, but separate from.
Well, there's a lot more than the water main issue, according, if you read Aaron's, I mean, I didn't.
Well, they just came in.
The one that just came in like 6:01, yeah.
When I get home.
Yeah.
That's fine.
I mean, otherwise, there was the issue of, you know, Aaron had mentioned a couple of things to me last week, but he says, you know, we'll get these things straightened out, no worries. But this was a, you know, a lot more.
It's been a battle since they've, you know, come on the job, you know.
Yeah.
I say A to the foreman, he's like, no, B. But everything I say, I mean, you're not following your SWIP plan, where is it? Bah. Where's your invasive species plan? Bah. I'm like, all right, I just mark it down in my book, saying, you know, so I got a full logbook of everything this foreman has said. And I'll ask him off to do something, don't do that, don't mix your materials, don't mix your organics with your gravel. It's two separate materials, bah, don't worry about it. So.
Well, so Aaron has called for a meeting tomorrow morning at 6:30 a.m. with Parker, or a Parker rep. Jeff will be there, that's what I just asked, and Aaron will be here. So, and they're not to work until I get these things straightened out. Is what, I believe that's what, how I read that. So they're gonna have to figure this out. You know, we've done our homework and they had good references, so sometimes.
I think it's this particular.
It could be that they're a little overextended and maybe this is.
No excuse.
I'm not saying it's an excuse, I'm just, you know, I agree with you.
We don't need to, Aaron's gonna handle it on our own now.
Yeah.
Yeah, in the end, he has the ultimate power to say, or whatever he wants to, I can't be like, you know, get done, he has to.
And yeah, it's our engineers.
Okay.
We're the plant, our engineer.
Well, again, thank you for giving them a call, which is how we set it up. I mean, Jeff was supposed to call the engineers when something like this transpired, so, okay, thank you.
Anything else that you guys need?
Isn't that enough good news?
So what we have, a couple of things.
A couple of, so the field mowing, not field mowing, roadside mowing that's happening at the end of September.
Yep.
This is the company who is, what's the company name?
Billy Reno, it's a Reno Mowing or Excavation, it's a construction company, but he also mows.
Could you spell that last name?
R-E-N-A-U-D.
Okay, where, from where?
South Broward.
South Broward. So, does he know what he's doing? I mean, how much oversight should we try to provide? Does your assistant, is it Wayne, is that his name?
Yeah, so, yes, you always send somebody with him. I send a chase truck with him because he, you know, blows sticks out on the road or whatever, so he can keep mowing, we'll pick the stuff that we had in the road. And if four ones, the vehicle's coming up behind you that they're mowing or whatever. And I did make a list though.
So you've got the route? Okay.
Yeah.
Okay, thank you. And what about snow plow routes? And the vehicles that do the snow?
I can make a rough list.
Yeah, just, you know, just so we can have, it's not that somebody coming in may want to change them, but it's good to have a starting point. I mean, I'm sure we can send Caroline over to the site when she's back to write it down or.
I'll be gone. I'm on vacation Thursday.
I thought it was Friday was your first day.
Well, Friday, excuse me.
I think she's back Thursday, so if there's time.
Oh, she is, okay, that she can just come over and.
Or maybe, or you can jot it, however it works. You know, it would be nice to at least get a starting point.
Is this the last time we're gonna see you then?
It will be.
We'll be back in September. For a day or two.
But we won't. Won't be meeting.
That's true, won't be meeting.
So.
Well, thank you.
Well, no, I was gonna say that I was gonna say at the end, I know that anything else we're gonna talk about.
No, other than I'm in the middle of preparing for my family reunion, but I don't know that I'm gonna show up at 6:30 and I'm sure Aaron will check in with me too. But obviously if there's something, I guess I'll wait to hear from Aaron, which is.
Yeah, I don't think anybody needs to be there. So it's gonna be between the contractor and pretty much the engineer.
Okay. All right, well, thank you.
Yes, thank you for
I'm sorry you can't see this project through.
I appreciate all the talent. Congratulations on your new position.
Caroline has my number, so if there's any questions or whatever, you can show.
Pretty strong,
thank
you.
All right. Thank you, Jeff. Have a good week. Denise was here. Denise is
no longer. I think she probably gets something out of her car.
Okay. All right, so let's take a look. Set the plant review fees, that's just we're setting up a September meeting for.
Okay.
Tom to come talk to us. I don't have the.
You have minimum housing somewhere else on the agenda.
I don't think I think we might have put it on hold. So let's talk about minimum housing standards.
I met with Tom today. He was in agreement that there were a few amendments that had been placed in the other document that we have, or one the current one that we have. We can't find the signed copy of, but that. Removes all responsibility from landlords from actually having to comply with these things, grandfathering all of them. So there's really no point of actually doing it. So suggested just taking out sections D, First of all, we're gonna need to renumber it because it's the Dover ordinance. They never changed that, so we need to change it. So it'll be Article 2, 119-9, Section D. This is the one about grandfathering all units that have more than one unit in them. I'll just leave that out there for what it is.
Well, what's the best way to get these edits, these suggested edits in place? Is this something that you can work with Caroline with?
Yeah, and then he suggested removing any damage that, remember when I was saying, we were reading that the same way last 2 weeks ago, where there was the section that.
Water heater or the?
The failure of the heating, the plumbing, electrical, structural deficit, or failure caused by the actions of both the landlord and the tenant. So something could be that you have a landlord that doesn't properly maintain their building, and the heating goes out, and they're gonna stick the tenant with the repair bill. So, no, you would suggest striking that one as well. And then we had changing the basement, definition of basement and cellars. Portion of any dwelling located partly underground but having less than 50% of its clear floor to ceiling height, and they have suggested 40, but he thinks 50 is more reasonable, both for cellar and basement. So.
Okay.
But that was only it, but the other, he said the only other changes would be to delete those three sections that we talked about that absolve landlords of any responsibility.
Yeah. So, okay, so you, did you say?
And then also, so the garbage, remember we were talking about having
units. Dumpsters?
Three or four, whatever the magic number, probably four or more units must have a dumpster. He said that Dover has a separate ordinance just dealing with garbage, you can get us that information.
Ah, very
good. He wasn't gonna be back. You get to me tomorrow, probably, or the next day.
All right. So do you feel comfortable sitting with Caroline?
Yes.
Okay.
We can renumber this, so it actually makes sense.
Yeah, right. That sounds good. Well, thank you. Sounds like it was a productive meeting. Very good. Anything else you might want to say about that? Perfect. Okay. So highway, we talked about roadside mowing. Jody's working on transfer station damage. And search committee. So, Mike, Jody and I talked about formulating a search committee. And so far we have Michael Point who's agreed to be on it, Jason LaVoy who's agreed to be on it, and Nate Mears.
Perfect.
So, and then we need an ex officio. And I prefer not to be on it. So if you, I don't know if it's awkward for Jody to be on it. I mean, she has a lot of interest there. I don't think so. I mean, there's no. So I think she's willing to do it. And her last suggestion was perhaps a budget committee.
Yeah, I agree with that. So the budget committee makes sense.
Yeah. Now, they're not meeting. So one, I'm just going to turn right now to two budget committee members who are sitting right here. Would one of you like to be on the search committee for?
You can send an email out to
the road agent.
Not that I don't think either of them would do
it. You want it? I will.
All right, I will say
pending, but sending it out to budget committee
I'll
in case somebody else.
Has a burning desire to mine.
Okay.
This is the nice interview for sure. As part of this discussion,
yes,
I had a conversation with a few folks today, here and elsewhere, and I've been thinking about this a little bit myself. It's always dangerous, but we should probably think we're in a unique position as we're reformulating or going to be able to reformulate what a road agent should or could do for our town, right? We should probably look at contracting plow service.
Yeah, it's always the case with the police. It's the case with the
For the police, it appears it's not going to make any sense. It's complicated from the research that Charlie's done on our behalf. But, you know, maybe it would make sense. We would have to buy a plow truck. Maintain them, we'd have to have some fleet of vehicles, not quite as extensive probably that we have now, I'm assuming. So that would help with the CIP.
It's really expensive. We're small
town.
Well,
that's just it. So,
for us to
manage. That's not to say
we have a hard time getting plow drivers.
Yes.
But it's so we'll have to look at the cost of that.
Well, I had mentioned that, you know, while we were sort of in a bind, past winter. We contracted with a local company. Like, well, yeah, but they had you, you know, you weren't putting out an RFP, actually. You had no choices at that point, really, right? So you could put out a request to a number of companies, I guess.
We would need to have some, so you lose your.
Well, obviously, there's a level of service too that people may have come to expect too, that they may not receive too, so we'd have to have that conversation. They get warrants.
I absolutely agree, absolutely. This is the time to do it.
Committee, I don't know if it's, makes sense for them at the same time or.
If it takes more time, I don't know, but I mean, I think it's worth.
I think some of those folks though are well positioned to know people that might be interested in doing that type of work.
Yeah, and we need somebody who would be able to write the RFP.
Mark Kuchar also had mentioned this to some folks in the front office that he knew some people. He rattled off a list of companies, it wasn't people that had a connection with, which is, that might be someone that could do it for us as well. So he might be someone we could reach out to as well. So it just makes sense to me for,
We're not gonna solve this tonight, but the.
Should be on the radar.
Yeah, I mean, we could, the roads, I don't mean plow, but the roads, we would just need somebody to help us assess,
Well, I mean, I think there's probably a lot of the traditional responsibilities of the road agent that would still need to be done. But if we take plowing is a huge piece right from the winter time, but.
Are you talking about, so you're not talking about not filling the position, you're talking about.
Oh, no, you're still gonna need a road agent, it doesn't mean you're gonna need someone that's at the same level. We wouldn't expect the same level of service or responsibility that we're expecting now, because at least, I think it's a quarter of the position, he or she wouldn't be responsible. Maybe it's more than, I don't know, how much plowing and all the.
Well, we're not paying hourly, right? So it's a salaried position.
Right.
So. Well, it would be something for the committee to think about.
Well, maybe we wouldn't wanna go out, I mean, I don't know. Maybe not, but.
Yeah, I mean, if you're not managing all that equipment, then it may not be sufficient there.
We've had issues with the transfer station, management of the transfer station. Is that something that the road agent should be handling? I know we toyed around with the idea of having a supervisor, a separate supervisor for that. Maybe that falls back on the road agent. I don't know, but that's what I'm looking for that, to that search committee to help write the job description also too, so we don't. We had really a job.
We got a good one from Northwood that Jody emailed us last week. So sometime. That always bears looking at. I thought you meant sort of contracting all of our road services.
I don't know if you'd be able to do that actually. But
because then if you're contracting out the snow plowing, I don't know if there's enough there to warrant a position that you hire somebody.
I mean, there were a lot of things, though, there's still a lot of things we're asking of our current road agent that just aren't enough hours in the day, but want to do every single thing, to what we're expecting. So, certain times of year, the plan is strategically devoted, and I don't.
Yeah. Well,
maybe it wouldn't work, but I think it's just an issue.
Yeah, absolutely. I agree with you. All right. Do you have any other insights or comments about that? And you're okay with Jody?
I know.
The world
changes.
Turns upside down.
I'm fine.
Okay.
Yeah.
All right. All right. Removal of shed. We don't have any information on that.
The person just not being responsive?
Yeah, I guess so. I don't know. Although Bob saw him, so I don't know what the story is.
Bob,
we still need somebody to write a contract for us. We don't have that. So. Denise, did you want to talk to us?
Yep, I'm here to see if there's still the $500 for the fireworks.
There is still $500.
And if I can submit a PO for it and get it processed.
Yes, do you need it, how soon do you need it?
A week or two is fine.
So if you can prepare a purchase order.
Yep.
Caroline will be back in the office, I think, on Thursday.
Okay. I'll come get one on Thursday and bring it in on Monday.
Yeah.
Okay.
And if she's not here, I think the front office has somewhere they can get you one.
Okay, all right.
So then we'll have it Monday, we can act on it Monday.
Okay, that'll be perfect.
And I think Caroline should be able to give you a check later that week.
That'd be fine, that will work out. We're very, very close, I do believe we're gonna make it, but.
Yay, that's great news.
Yeah, but I need to give them an answer by the 20th of this month, for sure. So I think we can make it, so we're gonna go for it. What's that? About 400, you know, but we're gonna see if we can have a table at the Legion breakfast for donations.
Yeah.
We're also gonna put out buckets out at each one. We did very well putting the bucket out in the Legion bar.
Oh, yeah.
So they were really generous last year.
That's great.
So we have several places in town that we're gonna do it. I'm pretty certain we can make it. So, but yeah, we had some people step up this last week.
Good, you're welcome.
And so we, and a couple of businesses also came forward too. So I, you know, I'm encouraged that we will at least have it for the fireworks. And we're going to try something this year, is maybe having like some kind of a winter event to help fundraise for the summer event. Some kind of event that what we can raise money on.
Yeah.
So we're gonna work on that after Family Day, but.
Maybe a movie night at the school or something.
Yep, you know like around the holidays, or you know, have a night where kids can come and parents can shop, you know, that kind of stuff. So,
oh yeah.
Yeah, for holidays. So yeah. So, and we're still planning on doing the outdoor movie thing.
Pardon?
We're still planning on doing the outdoor movie thing. I had to get through the wedding. That was yesterday. We're good. My son got married.
Oh, great.
Yeah,
congratulations.
Yeah, so now I have my mind back to Family Day.
It's amazing how an event like that can really just
take
all of your
Energy.
Yeah.
But so we are we're pretty confident that we're gonna have a good day, and we have a lot of events planned, so
excellent.
I feel good about it.
All right.
So, but I will take care of that.
Glad there's good news.
Yes, I think so too. So anyway, but thank you.
All right,
I'll
thank
do it
you,
this
Denise.
Week. Okay.
Okay. All right. So now we're at town administration project updates. The culverts. So well, we've already had a little bit of an update on the culverts. So there's going to be a meeting at 6:30 tomorrow morning with our engineers from Boyle Tanner and Parker and road agent to review some of the issues that are currently at play and to get things back on the right track. They also, Boyle Tanner, are working on construction oversight replacement. They had provided us with a commitment to have somebody for the 2 weeks that Jeff was on vacation, and then of course they had to go back to them not long after and said, oh, by the way, Jeff is now not going to be back when he's on vacation. So it's going to be expensive. And you know, there is some money in the plan, in the budget, so hopefully that will cover it until they come back and with a task order. I don't know what it is, and I prefer not to think about it until I see it, because my money printing press isn't working these days anyway, so.
Tree's still producing.
So. All right, and number two is just a placeholder, so we don't forget to do that when the project is over.
Okay.
All right, develop policy guidelines on Class 6 roads.
Yep.
So Michael, we received some guidance from our attorney, and did you have any thoughts on the recommendation?
I saw it when I was away.
It's New Durham's.
Right, but to be honest, I don't remember. I saw it, but I don't remember exactly what it said. Is it like 600, 500 foot buffer zone or something?
Well, so what Steve is suggesting, first of all, here he said, okay, here are some guidelines. Since I think they're good guidelines, they're not zoning ordinances. So the board itself could pass these.
Right.
And they're going to provide guidance to this board and future boards on what to do with regard to Class 6 roads. And so this guidance that New Durham wrote up does allow, it doesn't guarantee that a board will say yes to a building permit. But it says, okay, if you're within 600 feet of a class five, if the road is that, is wide enough, you know, if the residents, you know, will maintain it, you know, all those normal kinds of things, then the board could do that. It is no.
They don't have to, but they could.
They could. So what he suggests is that we look that over. If we think, in general, it's a good plan, then he will make it more Rollinsford-like. Present it to the planning board, because the planning board should review it. His suggestion is that we also have a public hearing before we adopt that policy or guidelines. That all makes sense. And that's, so I read it, and I think it's a good set of guidelines.
I did look at it when I was away, but so my understanding, New Durham, much like Rollinsford, did not have a written policy, my understanding, on building on class six roads. Now, they may have had something in their zoning, much like we do, but the select board themselves did not have a written policy on whether or not they would issue, because they're separation. And so that's where the Vashon versus New Durham case came in, blah, blah, blah.
I'm not familiar.
Well, this is like the case that we've all been looking at for
Okay.
I'm trying to separate, the two distinct issues. There's the policy going forward, and there's the ongoing issue of Shady Lane, right? So separating the two, even if we don't do anything with Shady Lane, or we do something with Shady Lane, we should at least have a written, we should have a written policy on how to deal with this, because there are other class six roads. There are other people that own property on the one we're talking about now.
Right.
That may want to do something.
It would have helped me as a board member to have something like this.
It would have helped the applicant, it would have helped us.
Right.
Yes. I need to go back and look at it again, but the concept, I think, is wonderful that we have a written policy.
Right.
I don't know if it's this one, but.
All right, so we'll give it a week then?
I apologize, I should have looked at it again.
But in general, the approach, if this set of guidelines is okay with you, then the approach of doing this as a policy adopted by the board.
I mean, there are other class six roads in town that will need to be addressed in the future.
Okay, the board received a right-to-know request that unfortunately we didn't really, weren't made aware of until a couple of days, two or three days after we got the right-to-know. So thank you for picking that up and emailing it. I don't have an email on him to let him know that we just received this, and do you know how to?
I don't.
Maybe we can ask Andrea to try to get in touch or leave a message. Do you want to try to get in touch with him and just say, we've received it, we're going to be working, Caroline's not here, we need to wait till she gets back?
Probably better coming from the board. Find out how to get over
there. All right, that would be super. And you saw that I asked the Municipal Association today, because a couple of the things, the first two things they're asking for are Avatar's field records, and they're not ours. So I just don't know what the answer is. And the other two are definitely things that we can assemble for you. All right, so would appreciate that if you could let him know. The right-to-know request came from Robert Meegan, M-E-E-G-A-N, and I don't know his name.
Janet.
Pardon?
I think it was Janet.
Robert and Janet Meegan. Do you know their road address? Just the street that they're on.
Locust.
Locust Street.
No, I'm on Locust. Locust. Thank you. All right. All right, so we'll be working on that. I don't have the MS 535 for us to sign. Old Mill Lane Bridge is a placeholder. Review transfer station fees. That was Jody's request.
Okay.
So we'll talk about that one.
The disposal fees again?
Yes. Rec committee, she's not here to talk about that. Utility assessment, nothing.
She called me today though about that, I'm sorry.
About the rec?
Yes.
Oh, okay.
It's about the water issue by the school.
Yes.
The school didn't have water. The kids couldn't go in to use the restroom, so they're on a field trip today, but now the porta potty for it.
Okay, thank you.
Yeah.
Utility assessment method, Caroline is trying to set up a meeting between one or two or three, all board members and Avatar to answer some questions. Anything to say in the non-lapsing account?
They canceled their meeting, when we were supposed to be before, before I went out of town. They have not rescheduled it, I'm aware of.
Okay, so we'll keep that, or do you wanna put it on hold?
We should keep it on there, but it's important, because it's just gonna keep coming up. And if it falls off, I'm looking for you, so.
Okay, that's fine.
Because they've been raising money, or they had it for those magnets, but they were selling magnets, so.
All right, Jody's working on job descriptions through joint loss.
Right.
Policies and procedures, we're continuing to work on welfare.
Okay.
And that's it for new and ongoing items, so now we just have the, sort of our standing items. Updates and activities, I have a Stratford Regional Planning Commission meeting on Friday, I will not be able to go to.
I didn't bring the notes with me, I called, I went to the TAC meeting the Friday before I went out of town.
Yep.
There's no new news on the 10-year highway plan, that's gonna be coming, more information October, I think. There was a presentation on the bike walk ped, bike walk, folks from New York DOT just discussing when you're doing road maintenance, you'll be thinking, you should be thinking more holistic. Like streets, sort of, not using all of those criteria, but just sort of thinking about it, but there's more people using the roads than just people in cars, so.
Yes, to wit, when I drove to town hall tonight, there was this caravan of bicyclists on Roberts Road that were occasionally two and three abreast. And at one point I made.
We had a spirited conversation about that too, I think, apparently our guideline.
Yeah. So fortunately, I made it here without, and I, at least.
Hurting anyone or yourself.
Not hurting anyone, exactly. Well, I hope all those bicyclists continue to have a safe ride this evening.
So that was about it.
Okay.
But I did go to one, so.
Thank you.
I had a handout, but I didn't know what, it's about the street.
You know, what's difficult, of course, is when you have streets, you have these colonial towns.
We mentioned that to them.
Yeah, that, you know, where your streets are barely wide enough for your cars.
The representative from Barrington was quite religious then, towards this guy, I was like, there was no need for it. Because the roads are very small.
Yeah, so it's a difficult situation.
Just sort of sit there and smile and just listen to the presentation.
I mean, it's good to keep in mind, and I agree with that, because there may be some cases, some instances where you could do something, but, I mean, look at Sligo, I mean, what would you do with Sligo? Right, it's so narrow.
But like with Wentworth Street, they made them put in sidewalks. You know, that probably should have happened down on Woods Run, that area. You know, places like that, there should be, there probably should be sidewalks.
Absolutely, so as a planning board rep, I mean, that it's a good time to.
Yeah, no, that is the time to do it, but so, I mean, those are, it's not all about putting bike lanes in there, there could be, anyways, but, and they're not always practical, so. But that would be some of the things that we do.
Okay.
The police space needs a meeting with next.
Not this week, but all.
We got, it's coming up, so 20, so we're having a count there, 29.
No, week before that. 24.
The 24th, yeah, 6 p.m., yeah. That's it.
Okay. Folder work then.
Folder work. All right, first thing we have this evening is a letter from the Lettys. This is the, these are the folks that tried to reach out to Avatar, but the mail got sent to the wrong address. They own property in town, but they live in Portsmouth. They must be the landlords, they live on property in Franklin, so. They tried to, they didn't have any luck with Avatar, so Andrea arranged for one, much like she can do with Mr. Chase.
Yeah, that's what we saw in the email.
So she just wanted us to be aware of that.
Okay.
Next is a building permit, 2017-090, for 27 Wentworth Street.
We We'll pass it on to you.
Yes, so you can see it. It is, putting, it's one of the new constructions. They are putting in a gas fireplace from having it vented. It's been reviewed by Mr. Clark, there's a $90 fee. One more, I believe. Building permit 2017-074, 58 Heritage Drive. They are putting in a pool. Adding above ground pool and electrical underground conduit. Mr. Clark has reviewed it. They were going to also do some deck work and stuff, but they're not doing all that now. So it's a, it is a 55-dollar fee. Takes a while. Everything's crossed out and countering what Tom had said and everything else. So it certainly was reviewed. You can see that. All right, we have a purchase order. It is from the cemetery trustees. It's purchase order number 1279 to Green Shadow Property Maintenance. This is for mowing of the new and old town cemeteries and trimmings for $1,345.
I'll second. Any questions? All those in favor say aye.
Aye.
Aye. Do you want us to wait a minute or two while you catch up?
No, no.
Okay.
You good? Okay. Say that now. We have abatements for elderly exemptions.
Oh, we usually do that in, is it abatement or do we do that in non-public?
These are the awarding of them, so I don't know.
Yeah, we've been doing them in.
This isn't the
review?
This isn't the review, this is the actual awarding of them, so.
Oh, that we need to sign from our tax clerk?
Yeah, we need to.
Oh, okay, so we just can start.
Fine. So don't we give the information?
I don't know.
Oh, we did.
Yeah, it's in the books, right? Exemption, so yeah.
It doesn't say how much, right?
Mm-hmm. So we'll just sign.
It's
just
how much.
Well,
yeah, right?
I think so.
Yes.
So these are folks for whom we didn't have the appropriate material in time, so that's why they're getting abated.
Right.
For the, you know, the
right.
Most recent tax.
Yeah, so are we.
So yeah, we're fine. We can just issue the abatements.
Oh, yeah. They are. Okay, it is actually in there. Yeah. How much they get. So. I just want to make sure.
Yeah, no, I do. So, no, I appreciate that. I, you know, I'm never sure. I'm a little
bit. Not to embarrass or anything.
Right.
Else or
so.
Okay, okay. So the first is to the collector of taxes, sir. By vote of the select board upon the application, earlier it's on so many different levels. Bertrand Lucette, or Lucette Bertrand. Individual is entitled to an abatement of $1,149.
No, we didn't sign it.
The next is Mildred Marshall is abated $1,399 for elderly exemption. Both of them, so I should say. Kathleen Adams, also elderly exemption, $1,399 abated. Virginia Kimball, also elderly exemption, is abated $56.
This is your agenda. This is coming back to us.
Okay, that's going your way. All right. And that's all I have in the red folder.
Yes, I think that came back.
So for Mr. Chase, am I, are you going to email Andrea or talk to her tomorrow?
Yes.
Okay, so I want to know, so you'll take her and I'll talk to her on the record.
Yes, and I will copy Avatar on that because I want to strongly urge them to try to get this person. So, and that Andrew can be our local go-between because Caroline's.
Extenuating, sir.
Yes. All right, anything else?
Oh, I have.
Okay, community input? Nancy?
When you were talking, the whole, that we got the whole grant, what was it? Did we cut the grant, did we cut the money in half at town meeting? Is that why we were?
No, the warrant article was for $75,000. 50 of it coming from the CIP.
Right.
And the other 25, we assumed, would come from a grant. That was the, what we thought. A month or so ago, Bob came to us and said, yeah, they're only going to give us a grant for 12, whatever, but it's okay because we can get it from somewhere else or we can cost share it. So it was still going to work, but this is better. So he came back to us tonight. Now he says, okay, they're giving us what is almost the full $25,000. It's not.
It was town hall security we were doing.
Yes, yeah, I remember that part. Okay. That was it.
Does that help?
Yeah.
Charlie?
Outsourcing the plowing, I think it's a very good idea to look into it. At least find out what the numbers are.
Yeah, I'll tell you, it's been expensive when we used Nick, but as, you know, as Mike said, I mean, those were sort of like in emergency situations. It's just, you know, you need someone who's going to put us on the top of the list. If not on the top of the list, what does that mean? Right? It means that people are going to have to wait. So, but it's an opportunity to think about, to think creatively about.
It's still,
services.
How do you juggle? Okay, how much salt do we need? How much time do we need for plowing and everything? You know, at least.
Repairs on trucks.
The repairs, we don't talk about that.
There's clearly.
It's something to look into, get an idea.
There's, yes. Do you want your, is this an extra agenda?
That's it.
So I agree. It's.
It may not work, but.
It's the perfect opportunity to look at.
I think we have done it in the past years.
And even looking at it, it's helpful to show the town what, you know, what we found out.
What our options are.
Exactly. I did hear from one of the people about to be in the search committee that, you know, it's hard to find these people and they're going for top dollar.
We know that too, yeah.
So.
But unless you look.
Unless you look, you never know.
I just need clarification. On the new fire truck that's coming in, when does the other piece that's going to be, you've got the money for it to be destroyed, when does that happen? Do they have time to learn the new fire truck before that happens?
The destruction?
Yes, when they have to leave Rollinsburg.
There's a number of days.
There is a number of days.
Yeah, I mean, if the grant is pretty, I don't remember.
Okay.
You know, I told Chief Rutherford that, you know, fairly soon, we're, you know, when these culverts are out of our head, we'll have to get together and re-familiarize ourselves with the conditions.
Okay, yeah.
You know, but because DES, you know, you have to let them know when you do it in case they want to send somebody.
Yeah, to witness it.
Yeah, to witness it. You know, if not, at the very least, we take pictures and they, you know, blah, blah, blah. And it is, it's within a certain number of days of something, of receipt. I don't know, but that's what we need to.
Because even though it's a fire truck and they know how to drive fire trucks, pumping is different, all of those, they should have some time to learn the new one, as long as that's within the guidelines, because you don't want to lose the money for that, clearly.
Well, it's a good point, you know, and if he looks at that, and if he says it's really onerous, you know, we can ask for a waiver, you know, extension.
Days extensions, yeah.
I just don't remember what it is.
Okay, I just wanted to make sure there was something there.
There is something.
Oh, good, that's good.
And he did review them.
Mark did?
Yeah, you know, it's one thing when you review them and it's, you know, 10 months away.
Yeah, exactly.
It's 11 or whatever.
Yeah, okay, thank you.
You're welcome. Anything else?
So
Michael, shall we go home?
Please.
All right, by consensus, we are adjourned, Corey. Again, thank you so much for stepping in.
Yeah.
So, who needs to share?
That was that first.